Hello and welcome to lesson 2 in the creation of our school management system. In our previous lesson, we dealt with how to design the homepage of the system. So in this lesson, we're going to deal with how to design the about page. About page basically is all about the system, description of the system and how the system works. So we create that page and then you can choose to add your text and then explain how your system works. So you can just create a new tab by pressing clicking the plus sign here. Then you can just double click it to name it about, or to rename it about. So you can give it a color of our choice. So right click, go to tab color, I think give it a red color, that would be ideal. So you go ahead and hide the first row as well. So you just select it, right click, and then hide. Then we hide the first column as well. They'll select it, right click, and then hide as well. So we are good to go. And I've already explained the reason why we are doing the hiding stuffs. So now what we need to do is to begin designing the home page. So we begin that without any stress. So we just start it and then we'll be good to go. So we start from here. I think that would be okay for us. To access row and then and then all that. Good. So you can just hide this by choosing a different background color for it. I think this color looks smart and not bad. So this is okay. So we can also get our text box here. So we go to insert. The insert tab, we look for a text box and then we get it up and running from here. So we can just draw our text box from here like this. So up to some certain level. Okay. Depending upon the length of your text, that will determine the size of your text box. I think this is okay. This isn't all that bad. So you can just drag it to meet this and then you're good to go. So I think this looks okay. So as usual, you can just select this and then you can go ahead and hide it again. Or you can just select the entire column here like this, the two, and then go ahead and hide it. So to this level, think to this. So we give it a white background and that will hide the various cells. We are not actually hiding the cells, but we are just using the background color just to deceive it in one way or the other. Let me put it that way. So you select this as well and then we do the same thing. Good. So white background just to hide it as well. So but with the remaining cells, yes, as I selected, do the same selection, control shift, then the right arrow, then we hide the entire cells from here. Then this as well, do the same thing from this angle. The bottom cells. So we just select this way, control shift, down arrow, then right click and hide. Good. We are good to go from here as well. So we can just select the remaining here. Okay, this if possible, let's just drag the text box just to meet this. Good. So I think this looks okay. So we have our text box up and running. So now what we need to do is just to get a description here at the top, just telling us about it. So we can just write about the system. So good, this looks okay. So you can just select it, merge and center, change the font style to Times New Roman, can bold it, can increase the font size a bit. Then we can give it a let's say the text color to be white, then background color to be this and be this color about the system. Good, this looks okay. So let's see if we can give it a thick border around it and then I think that will look okay for us. So let's just say, let's just start from here, right? Okay. So doing is like, get it from here. Okay, let's check that and see. Select it this way. Okay, let's check and give it a thick border around it as well. So I think this looks okay. So with this, we have our text box in the middle. Then things are working for us as expected. So let's just give it another thick border from here as well. So or maybe thick and thin at the top and all that. And that looks okay. this is actually not selected. So let's redo it again and see. Since okay, let's just check out this. Okay, this looks okay. So let's create another button here that will link us back to the home page or any other page. So to do that, we go to the Insert tab, go to Shapes, and then you choose this button. It looks good for creating buttons for navigate for the various hyperlinks and then other stuff. So you just create this and then move it to the top bit. Just right click to edit text and type on it home. Good. So you can just select it this way, center it, go to home and then center it, raise it a bit, change the font style to Times New Roman. Then you can bold it. So let's see if you can format it a bit. So let's check and see if we can quickly do that. And then that looks okay. I think we are good to go from this angle. Let's just reduce its size a bit. Good. It looks smarter than before. Well, this should link us to the home. So with this, you can just right click and then choose hyperlink. A click or you choose place in this document, then you choose home, and this looks okay. So when we click on this, we go to the home page. So let's just right click on this and do the same hyperlink, and then we would like to go to the about page. So you choose about to make sure place in this document is selected, then you click okay. We do that. So right click on this one as well, choose hyperlink. Since we want it to be on the home page as what we are seeing, you just click on home. Then okay, so we click on this, we should be on the same page since we are already on the home page. But we click on this, we should come to the about page. Click on this, we go back to the home page. So let's check here. So this is where you can write all the information and instructions on how the system works, detailed description, so that any user of your system that takes it to be able to follow these instructions and use the system without any stress. So I would like to end this lesson here as well in order not to prolong the video so much. And in our next lesson, we're going to create our student database table. So till we meet again in our next lesson, I say thank you for watching and don't forget to save your work. Control S to save the work. Thank you very much for watching.